Hi, Rhema. It's week 32, day 3 of our Bible narrative reading plan. Today we are in 2 Kings chapter 23. We continue in the legacy of King Josiah. Remember, we saw that he did what was right in the eyes of the Lord and walked in the ways of David, his father. We've seen so far that Josiah has instructed that the temple be repaired. And while that renovation was taking place, that repair was taking place, the book of the law, God's word, was found. It seems like in at first that Josiah has probably the book of Deuteronomy read to him, but now we see that in chapter 23 he wants to have all of the Pentateuch, all of Genesis to Deuteronomy, read aloud to the people. When Josiah first heard the word of the Lord in the reading of Deuteronomy, he began to mourn because he knew what was missing in Israel, how God was not blessing Judah because of their lack of obedience to God's word. So now in chapter 23, he gathers the people and he has read the law read aloud, Genesis to Deuteronomy read out loud. And then Josiah begins to enact these reforms, as what the label in your Bible, the heading probably says. But notice what he does. He begins to rip out and destroy all remnants of false worship. He has things taken out of the temple. He has things taken down in the land of Judah. But then he begins to expand that. He even goes into the northern kingdom of Israel. There's a point in time where he's able, he has enough military might that he goes there and he begins to rip out all of the different things, the Asherahs and the Baals and the altars to Molech and all of the abominable things that have been merged in, with syncretism, the blending of worship of God and the worship of false gods. All of this has been going on for generations in Judah, and he takes this out. He says this will not happen any longer. And then you look at verses 21 through 23, you see that Josiah reinstates the Passover. The Bible tells us that the Passover had not been observed since the time of the judges. Can you imagine? Since the time of the judges, Passover had been neglected, but Josiah restores the Passover. If you keep reading, it says he puts away all the mediums, the fortune tellers, all of these things that are wicked, that are evil. Josiah puts these away. And verse 25 summarizes, before him there was no king like him who turned to the Lord with all his heart and with all his soul and with all his might, according to all the law of Moses, nor did any like him arise after him. Josiah is one of a kind, in some ways even greater than David, because Josiah restores pure worship in the land of Judah. But this is not enough to stop the judgment that is coming. God makes clear that judgment is still going to come to Judah because of the sins of Manasseh, who reigned for 55 years in pure wickedness, and the sins of previous generations. So we have that summary statement that we often see, verse 28. Now the rest of the acts of Josiah, all that he did, are they not written in the book of Chronicles? But it also tells you that Pharaoh Necho, the king of Egypt, went up to the king of Assyria. And when Josiah goes to meet Pharaoh Necho, for whatever reason, they're together, and Pharaoh Necho kills Josiah. So this is the end of his life, his reign as king. His son Jehoaz is made king for a time, but then he's taken captive by Pharaoh Necho. He's taken to Egypt, and now his brother is placed on the throne. Notice that Josiah had at least two different wives, because these sons are sons of different mothers. And so this reminds us that even as good as Josiah was, he certainly was not a perfect king. But we see that Pharaoh Necho puts Josiah's other son on the throne, changes his name in a way to show that he has authority. Jehoiakim means that God is the one who provides, the one who's in charge. But now he changes it to Eliakim, saying that the Lord is the one. And this would mean that Pharaoh Necho was Lord, not Jehovah being Lord. So Pharaoh Necho is trying to assert his authority there in Judah. But Jehoiakim does not reign well. Verse 37 tells us he did what was evil in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his fathers, plural, had done, pointing back to his grandfathers and all the other kings who had reigned poorly there in Judah. Here's a summary of today's reading. For more information, go to tunemyheart.org.